Modern humanity uses nuclear weapons to access the destructive abilities that control the forces which unite all things in the universe. A single contemporary nuclear weapon outperforms all World War II explosives by producing energy, which destroys cities and kills hundreds of thousands of people while creating prolonged suffering from radiation and social breakdown throughout multiple generations. The explanation of human discovery of such devastating capability begins with how we unlocked its power. This history consists of physics discoveries during wartime combined with political tensions and espionage activities and moral dilemmas. The scientific study of atomic structure started in peaceful contemplation, then evolved into an ongoing threat that drives modern geopolitical dynamics. This detailed history examines scientific concepts along with essential characters throughout crucial events and ongoing dilemmas. The atom unveiled, from curiosity to cataclysm. Human beings started their search for understanding matter, which established the foundation of everything. Scientists previously considered atoms indivisible, but scientists discovered their intricate structure. Marie Curie led the way by studying radioactivity alongside Ernest Rutherford, who discovered the nucleus, and Niels Bohr, who defined atomic structure. Albert Einstein achieved a revolutionary scientific breakthrough by creating E=mc2 through his relativity theory, which demonstrated the substantial energy present in mass. A Berlin laboratory under Otto Hahn and Fritz Strassmann performed an experiment which Lisa Meitner and Otto Frisch interpreted as the discovery of nuclear fission. This discovery went beyond basic physics because scientists found evidence of a promising power source which could serve as either an energy generator or an explosive weapon. World War II transformed theoretical discoveries into an alarming competition to create the ultimate weapon. The beginning of war converted scientific theory into a deadly weapons competition. The understanding of nuclear implications became clear to scientists Leo Szilard and Edward Teller and other refugee physicists during that time. Einstein, together with Szilard, warned President Roosevelt about Nazi Germany's potential atomic bomb development in 1939 because they feared Werner Heisenberg would lead the project as a brilliant but immoral scientist. President Roosevelt started the massive secret research project known as the Manhattan Project after receiving the Einstein-Szilard warning in 1939. The scientific leadership of CRJ, Robert Oppenheimer, and military oversight of General Leslie Groves directed this unprecedented industrial scientific military operation that began in 1942. The Manhattan Project achieved both groundbreaking accomplishments and terrifying consequences. The project spent more than $2 billion, equivalent to $30 billion today, while utilizing more than 130,000 personnel in multiple secret cities to face significant operational hurdles. Oak Ridge, Tennessee, enriched uranium-235 using massive electromagnetic separators and gaseous diffusion plants. Hanford, Washington, produced plutonium-239 in nuclear reactors, a new element barely discovered in 1940. Los Alamos, New Mexico, Project Y, the bomb design laboratory directed by Oppenheimer. Scientists at this facility encountered enormous physical obstacles and faced ethical dilemmas regarding the weapon, while debating intensely about its moral implications. Two bomb designs emerged: the simpler uranium gun type, Little Boy, and the more complex plutonium implosion type, Fat Man. Trinity, the world changes imaikyo, first atomic device using plutonium implosion technology, detonated at the Trinity test site located in New Mexico desert on July 16, 1945. A massive explosion equivalent to 20,000 tons of TNT illuminated the pre-dawn sky like the sun while creating trinitite by fusing desert sand and sending a massive mushroom cloud reaching heights of miles into the atmosphere. The shockwave shattered windows 120 miles away. The witnesses experienced a mix of awe and terror as they observed the explosion. During the explosion, Oppenheimer remembered the Bhagavad Gita where he said, "Now I am become death, the destroyer of worlds." The explosion turned all men into sons of bitches, according to Kenneth Bainbridge, who spoke with Oppenheimer. The beginning of the nuclear age had finally arrived. The devastating atomic bombings took place at Hiroshima and Nagasaki. After Germany fell, Germany ceased to be a threat, so the Pacific War continued. President Truman made a decision to use atomic bombs because the estimated number of deaths in a Japanese invasion reached millions. The uranium bomb, Little Boy, reached 1,100 feet before detonating above Hiroshima on August 6, 1945. An estimated 70,000 to 80,000 people died instantly from the blast combined with heat wave, reaching 7,000 degrees, and radiation pulse. The blast destroyed everything while leaving behind vaporized human forms which burned into building walls. By year's end, the death toll reached $340,000 due to injuries and radiation sickness. 3 days later, August 9, 1945, the plutonium bomb Fat Man exploded over Nagasaki, killing 40,000 immediately, with deaths rising to 74,000 by year's end. Japan surrendered on August 15. Scientists continued to debate about the necessity of atomic bombing to conclude the war and protect lives. The scientists conducted mass terror actions by demonstrating to the Soviets, or did they have to use nuclear attacks against civilians in order to save lives? Declassified documents demonstrate Japan actively pursued surrender terms, yet insisted on preserving the emperor. The Cold War arms race, mutually assured destruction, MAD. The United States lost its nuclear monopoly in 1949 because the Soviet Union detonated its first atomic bomb known as Joe 1, after receiving substantial espionage assistance from the Manhattan Project. This incident launched the Cold War nuclear arms race. The United States tested the Ivy Mike hydrogen bomb during 1952, which released 10.4 megatons of energy, equivalent to 700 times the power of Hiroshima. The USSR followed in 1953. These bombs used fusion, fusing hydrogen isotopes, releasing energy orders of magnitude greater than fission bombs. Proliferation, the UK, 1952, France, 1960, and China, 1964, joined the nuclear club. Delivery systems. Bombers gave way to intercontinental ballistic missiles, ICBMs, and submarine-launched ballistic missiles, SLBMs, creating invulnerable second-strike capabilities. MAD doctrine. By the 1960s, both superpowers possessed thousands of warheads capable of destroying each other many times over. The doctrine of mutually assured destruction, MAD, emerged. Nuclear war meant suicide. Stockpiles reached their peak at more than 70,000 warheads globally during the mid-1980s. Brinkmanship and close calls. Living on the edge, the Cold War included multiple terrifying crises which occurred throughout its duration. The Cuban Missile Crisis, 1962, proved to be the most dangerous situation. A 13-day crisis occurred after Soviet missiles were detected in Cuba, while nuclear war seemed possible. The United States prevented catastrophe through secret negotiations, which included a commitment to withdraw missiles from Turkey. Other incidents. Several technical system failures and mistaken interpretations of natural phenomena as missile launches created close calls during both the Yom Kippur War, 1973, and other incidents which demonstrated how fragile nuclear deterrence was the modern landscape proliferation. Treaties and new threats nuclear weapons exist after the Cold War period ended. Five countries joined the nuclear club after the Cold War ended, including India, 1974, Pakistan, 1998, and Israel, undeclared, and North Korea, 2006, obtained nuclear capabilities. South Africa developed then dismantled its program. Iran is widely suspected of pursuing weapons capability. Treaties and arms control, crucial but fragile tools. Non-proliferation treaty, NPT, 1970, aims to prevent spread, promote disarmament, and allow peaceful nuclear energy. Criticized for creating nuclear haves and have-nots. START treaties, I-2 New START, bilateral U.S.-Russia agreements reducing deployed strategic warheads, New START limits to 1,550 each. New START is currently strained. Comprehensive Test Ban Treaty, CTBT, 1996, bans all nuclear explosions. Not enforced due to key holdouts, U.S., China, India, Pakistan, Israel, Iran, Egypt, North Korea. Persistent threats. modernization, major powers, US, Russia, China, are spending trillions upgrading warheads, delivery systems, and infrastructure, potentially fueling a new arms race. Regional tensions, India-Pakistan conflicts, North Korea's missile tests, Iran's program, and Russia's nuclear threats over Ukraine keep the risk of nuclear use alarmingly present. Non-state actors, the nightmare scenario of terrorists. Acquiring fissile material or a crude device remains a major security focus. Accidental war, complex launch systems, cyber vulnerabilities, hacking early warning systems, and human error remain inherent risks. The unanswered question, abolition or enduring threat? Nuclear weapons persist as the most dangerous threat, which endangers the existence of all humanity. A large-scale nuclear war would create nuclear winter, which would destroy agriculture and end civilization. The doctrines of deterrence have continued to justify their continued existence. The International Campaign to Abolish Nuclear Weapons, ICAN, received the 2017 Nobel Peace Prize to advocate for the Treaty on the Prohibition of Nuclear Weapons, TPNW, which bans all development, testing, production, possession, and utilization of these weapons. The treaty has no support from any nation that maintains nuclear weapons capabilities.